Looking back, a mistake made in MMA has been to build your champion. Vince McMahon was looking to buy the UFC. And when he was a suitor for it, he was going to buy the product and shut it down. Are you aware of that?
No.
He wanted it off pay-per-view. He did not want competition. And Shane, his son, loved it. Goes, no, let's build this and run it. I'll run. I love MMA. And Vince goes, no, absolutely not. You can, and here's Vince's quote. You cannot build a star unless you can control the outcome. And an MMA will never make it because it will never have stars because you don't control the outcome. That was his thought. Now, to have that mindset is because you're trying to build the champion. And MMA, Bellator's guilty of it too. UFC's guilty of it. As soon as a guy gets the belt, the media changes. Okay, here's what we do with our champions. You're now going to be doing this press tour, and we're going to get you on the cover of this magazine. And it's this hot game of hot potato. And the champion's the champion for a number of months, and he loses the belt. If he could hold that belt for a year, if he could defend. I can remember when Stipe defended twice at heavyweight. It set a record. It had never been defended twice. I didn't even realize that. That's how fast those belts were jumping around. You sit back a little bit and you go, okay, let's analyze why. First off, in MMA, they're always taking on the top contender. There is no protection. And that's universal. Coker protects nobody. Dana protects nobody. You're going to fight anybody. So that's going to add to it. But also, Jacob, and I want to offer you this. When they were following the recipe that we're going to build our champion, and once you win the championship, we send you on a media tour and open opportunities that are select for the champion. You've now changed a guy. A guy is now living out of a hotel room. He's now not geographically in the same location where his trainer and his teammate and his gym is. He's now not doing the same things that led him to that championship. So when you do different things, you're going to get different results. That's one part of it. What I offer you to you, the mistake was. And so then what happens? The guy's no longer the champion. You throw him to the end of the line and you bring the new guy out and you send him on the media tour and you try to make him, and then he loses and you try to do it with somebody else. I think in hindsight, we should all agree that was a mistake to build a champion. The general recipe of promoting says you build champions. I'm suggesting to you, if you're not willing to control the outcome like Vince does or to protect your champion like Bob Arum and Don King will do, if you're going to do what Coker and Dana do, which is you're going to take on the top guy, no protection here. If you're going to do that, then instead of building a champion, let's just build fights. Instead of thinking a long-term play and trying to find the next Conor or the next Manny Pacquiao or the next guy that's going to have a big long run, instead of doing that, let's just spend 8 weeks and build a fight. And a lot of people don't like that model because it's short-sighted. I disagree. I don't think everything in business has to be a visionary. I don't think everything in business has to be chess. I think if you have 8 weeks and you have a media cycle and you can build a fight, which would speak to, you know, so many people are going to say, I guess what brought this up to remind the listeners now that I've ranted here for 6 minutes, but you had talked about Tyron versus Khabib. Well, yeah, that is possible. It's not possible under old Dana mindset. Dana has changed and is now allowing guys to float around. But then he's met with the same resistance of every time of, okay, what do I do with this belt? Do I just strip the guy? Do I intern the guy? Do I let a guy go back? What in the hell do I do here? Who cares? Figure that out. Yeah, strip him. Intern him. Do whatever you want. Doesn't matter. Does not matter. Let's not focus on the division or the champion of that division. Let's just focus on the next big fight. Build everything around a fight. Different mindset to the promoting model, but I think it would solve some of those problems. And I think the parity that we're able to get by allowing guys to go outside of their weight class and bounce and move around like we've seen the boxers do, I think it makes it a lot of fun. You know, I think the biggest and most fun fight we're going to get in 2018 is Stipe versus DC. I think it is compelling for a number of reasons, and I think when they finally start to do the build and the media on that, I think we're just going to be on the edge of our seat with anticipation. I really do. And I think we can duplicate that a lot of different ways. I think that TJ and DJ, we're not going to get that anymore as of now. I think it was a big miss on DJ. I think he undervalued himself on that. I don't think he realizes how many of us were willing to pitch in and make sure he got what he felt he was worth. But I think you can play that game a lot. I like the new mentality. I like the new Dana mentality. I hope he keeps it. Let these guys dance around, man. They want to go get belts. Let them go get them. It means something. Don't build the champion. Let's start building the fight.